Any question?
Good evening, Dr. Zakir. And my name is Beryl D'Souza. I'm from Bombay. Tonight, I must thank you for the wonderful lecture. And I must tell you that I used to see you on the television and follow your lectures ever since, since the past some years when I was in college. Tonight, I would like to ask you a question. First of all, I would like to tell you two things. You said two things. One was like, associating anything with God is a sin. It's the biggest sin, rather. The second thing you said, that the form of prayer is that the Muslims follow, is that you put your forehead down and it humbles yourself. Now, myself being from Bombay, I would, because this is something I've noticed there, I would also like to know clearly what is the concept about the dargahs that people go to and the people follow.
The sister asked a very good question. You're asking a question regarding the Muslims now. And it's a very intelligent question. She says that in Islam, if associating partners with God is the biggest sin, and the best form of worship is to prostrate, then what happens in dargahs? People go to dargah and they prostrate. So is it right or is it wrong is the basic question. Sister, I do agree with you. You have understood my lecture very clearly and very correctly, that associating partners with God, anyone does, it is wrong. Whether he calls himself a Muslim or non-Muslim, whether he calls himself John, Abdullah, Zakir, Muhammad, anyone who associates partners with God, he is doing the biggest sin. And we can prostrate to no one but to Almighty God. So anyone who prostrates to anyone besides Almighty God, he is doing shirk. He is associating partners with God. So if any human being goes to any grave and he prostrates to that grave and he worships that grave, he is doing the biggest sin, irrespective whether he calls himself a Muslim or non-Muslim.
Does the sister have a connected question?
So, okay, if you would give me the opportunity, I would further like to ask you. So, basically, I've seen, like you said, anybody, okay, be it a Muslim, a Christian, a Hindu, whoever does that. Now, if I tell you, from what I have seen and known, is like a huge percentage, okay, they are the people, I could call them the Muslims. They go to the dargahs. Then what would you have to say about it?
See, as far as the Arabic word Muslim is concerned, a true Muslim is a person who submits his will to God. A true Muslim will never bow down to any grave. I am aware, sister. I wouldn't say that you are wrong, you are right, that there is quite a large quantity of so-called Muslims who bow down to these graves. What do I have to say? I feel they are doing wrong. They are doing shirk. They have to change. And that's what, in my talks, I even tell them, that if you want to go to a grave, the Prophet said that you can go to a grave, it reminds you of your akhirah, that one day you have to die. So when you go to a grave, you can pray for the person, but you can't pray to him. You can pray for him, that may Allah give him Jannat Firdaus, may he forgive his sins, etc. But you can't pray to him. Prayers should only be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. They alone we worship, they alone we ask for help. So my talks are even targeted to these Muslims, and I tell them also that I have given other talks, that you should not worship, you should not prostrate to graves. This is wrong, it's a big sin. And alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, since you are from Bombay, I'm also from Bombay, there are thousands of youngsters, mashallah, after my talk, who have stopped worshipping graves. Alhamdulillah. Hope that answers the question.